Let's talk to Dr. Alan Mendoza, who is Executive Director of the Henry Jackson Society. Doctor, good evening to you.
Good evening.
What's all the fuss about?
Well, the fuss is about that we've got someone here who, it is absolutely correct that she left this country as a teenager. Went, of course, to join Islamic State. Then, during the course of her time there, when she was indeed part and parcel of that society, has shown no remorse for her actions since passing into adulthood. Never tried to flee, as many of her contemporaries did attempt to do so, and now seemingly wants to come back to a country which she has reviled for many years. So there is, of course, an uproar about it, because the Home Secretary at the time made a sensible decision to say, if we can avoid bringing you back because you have access to other citizenship, we should take that option, rather than have you back here, where you can, of course, continue to pervert other young minds with the ideology that took you over there.
And you actually do believe that?
I absolutely believe it, yes. Because I can give you, there are plenty of examples.
No, don't bother, because now I realise the sort of person you are. So if your 15-year-old daughter had been groomed online and had been convinced with a few friends to go over to this country, you would have think then, whatever happens to her, it's own fault, and we shouldn't even try and get her back and look after her and maybe try de-rationalise her or whatever. You wouldn't think that. You think, as the father of a 15-year-old girl who was suddenly disappeared and went to a place like this, you'd be quite happy for her just to be left there, and you wouldn't want to see her again. Is that right?
I would, as her father, I would doubtless fly to her and look after her in that kind of respect. But whether I think she should return to this country, a country she has reviled, a country which she was helping, let's not forget.
She was 15. She didn't know her own mind.
Oh, come on. She was 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 while she was out there. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I would imagine.
That's not violent.
I would imagine when she got there.
She wasn't 10.
I would imagine when she got there.
There are different areas of legal responsibilities. You well know a 15-year-old has different responsibilities to 10-year-olds. They're not adults. I will accept that. And there is clearly a problem there in terms of radicalization in this country. But nonetheless, the idea that she is now entirely innocent is just not correct.
Now, my turn?
Of course.
Good. Everybody grows up at a different time. Some 15-year-olds are very immature. Some are easily led. But they really are not, you know, in a situation to make the definite decisions for the rest of their life. She was taken over with her schoolmates. They went over there thinking they were going to a new realization. I don't know what they were thinking, but they were obviously groomed online. A lot of people have said that. And they have obviously got sucked into it. You would if you were a kid, probably in a situation where if you didn't do what you were told, you'd get a bullet in the back of your head. This kid is completely and utterly brain damage, I suppose. She's had most of her senses, brainwashed is a better word, Ash, thank you. She's had most of her senses destroyed. She was born and brought up in this country, and now we are not accepting our responsibility. Our responsibility is to bring this girl back and to see what we can learn out of her, first of all, for the Secret Services. I think that will be a very good idea. And then she is to go into a psychiatric place and to be looked at and to be helped to get back to normal. That is the proper thing to do, surely.
You might very well think that, but I don't share that view. Because, as I said to you, there are plenty of examples of people who have followed exactly the same path
I'm sorry, but I'm not talking about anybody else except this one. I'm not talking...
Make an exception in that way. Because as you're well aware, this legal judgment that we've been told about today opens the doors for potentially 150 other people who've also lost their citizenship, many of whom, by the way, have committed many, many far worse crimes than anything anyone suggested about Shamima Begum, people who've actually got blood on their personal hands.
Yeah, well, they should be brought back here and they should be dealt with, not left over there. It is our responsibility. And I don't understand why a man presumably as intelligent as you are doesn't actually grasp the situation.
I grasp it perfectly well. You are denying any individual culpability in this example. I'm saying what individuals do matters. And that's the difference. And if you, there are certain crimes that are so heinous that if you have the option of avoiding national security problems by bringing them back to our country, where they can radicalize others and cause more bloodshed on our streets, then that is an entirely legitimate thing for the government to do.
You presume you're a doctor, for goodness sake. You must be intelligent enough to realize these people will be brought back. The younger ones will be given psychiatric help, I would hope, and detained. The other ones will be put in prison, and they would be dealt with by British justice. It is our responsibility. They are British. Whatever they choose to, or other people choose to say about them, and however terrible they've been, and the more terrible they've been, the more we should be looking to get them back here to punish them.
Except she rescinded her British citizenship herself, essentially, by pledging allegiance to a terrorist state that wanted to destroy
her. Because she was groomed.
Number two.
Because she didn't, groomed.
Unlike many others who were also groomed, she's not seen the error of her ways, she's not seen remorse, none of that.
God.
In that sort of way.
And you'd go running over there as her father, and you would bring your daughter of that age back, would you?
Absolutely. If I was her father, I would go and do everything I could to locate my daughter, see what I could do to rescue her, whatever it would take. I'm not suggesting her
doesn't
father,
that
by the
make
way, didn't try that. Didn't try that.
Doesn't that make you sound a bit silly, suggesting that you'd do that if you were her father? And yet, here you are talking for the Henry Jackson Society. And I'm a big fan of Boris Johnson and this government. I probably hate to see any other one in, but on this, they're all wrong. These people are our responsibility. They need to be brought back to this country, and they need to be dealt with here. And when you went over there when you were 15, went with your schoolmates, I'm sorry, but, you were not in your right mind.
It's no more.
I don't understand why you don't understand that.
Well, I don't understand why you don't think this woman is a potential extremist threat coming back to this country, inspiring others to kill and maim their fellow citizens. I'm not going to suggest.
Well, I'm sure there are people over here already doing that.
But they're not going to be encouraging blood on our streets. I'm not saying that, but I am saying there's a very real danger. Of course, I'm not going to do that. But I'm going to say to you, there's a very real danger that people like this, who are either poster children for ISIS, for future recruits, or themselves harbour such views that they would willingly radicalise others, are a very real and legitimate security threat to this country. And while I accept, of course, that you're acting out of the goodness of your heart to try and bring them back, or even out of some sense of justice of some kind, I also think you're not giving sufficient credibility to what this person might do when she returns, what groups which she is affiliated to would use her for, or would use her example for.
They won't get anywhere near her.
That's a very bold statement to make.
They don't need to get near her. Well, they do that, and those sort of people should be shut down immediately. Why aren't we doing it, eh? Why don't we actually go into societies who are in favour of these flipping terrorists, and why don't we start locking a few up who've already shown to be in favour of these terrorists? Don't matter how profile they are, why not get them behind bars and question them? If they're a threat, and I believe a lot of them are, why aren't they actually locked up now? They should be.
If they've broken the law, you're absolutely right. If they've glorified terrorism, which is one of the laws of our statute book, we absolutely should and must get them behind bars. And that is essentially the question of radicalism in this country, how we can resolve it. But you're right, it needs tough enforcement and a no low bar to this. You've got to have an immediate, if you've broken the law, we're going to get you for that.
And what if she was stateless and she didn't actually have a second country that she was in?
If she's stateless, then we have a clear legal obligation to bring her back. That's a very different matter.
But they won't accept her, will they, at the other... Is it Bangladesh? They wouldn't... And some of them have death penalties. So.
She was born in this country. Why should... Hang on. Why... That's a very good point, Ash. Why should she be... Go to... is it Bangladesh?
Her parents. It was her parents, weren't they? Yeah. Were from Bangladesh.
Why should she go there and be their responsibility when she was born and brought up in this country? She's British.
And they have the death penalty.
All this
for terrorism,
rubbish,
don't they?
I might agree with that, but first of all,
to be sent to countries where they could face the death penalty.
No, of course not. So it's just a load of rollocks. All this. Just people shutting their mouths off and trying to sound big. And all you're doing is trying to just placate yourselves by telling somebody else they should be dealing with it. We should be dealing with it, and we should be dealing with this whole thing far more seriously than we are. I think we're a little bit scared in this day and age of being called racist or whatever. You know, this is a problem that needs to be dealt with. But I'm sorry, I can't think a kid of 15 groomed online should be held responsible. That kid needs to be brought
back. What about
back
a kid of 18 who's groomed? I mean, they're just as, you know, brainwashed.
Yeah, well, you know, you don't have much 20. Life experience then.
Or 22, yeah, I mean, you're brainwashed then. I mean, you're going to let all of them
They off. they need, well, if they're British, yeah, bring them back and deal with them here. They need to be kept in detention and locked up before we decide what we're going to do with them, obviously.
Yeah, but you know we let them out early a lot here, you know, in this country.
Then maybe somebody needs to stop that stupid action. Maybe the government should pass a few sensible laws.
Yeah.
Well, it's moving in that direction, gents. You've seen the path of legislation stopping automatic early release, as you well know. Things are a lot better now than they used to be in that regard. But you're right, there's lots more that can be done, and we are never going to drain the swamp of radicalization or extremism unless we get to grips with some of the core problems of ideology.
Do you think she would be celebrated as well by, you know, certain terrorist organisations if she did come back?
Oh, absolutely.
If she came back and was celebrated.
Yeah,
well,
no doubt.
Then those organisations need locking up. Lock them up. Lock those organisations up.
Well,
in fact, I'm beginning to think we should get rid of religion in this country. You know, we are a state which is almost secular, yet we have a state religion. I think we should say, you know,
everybody's free to... But it sets a precedent, doesn't it, as well? It means any kid can go out there and then just come back and they'll be all right, you know what I mean? They should face...
They're not going to be all right. What makes you think that we're going to bring these people back and they're going to be all right? They're not. This is just ridiculous. Anyway, I have to move on. But, Alan, thank you very much indeed. I can't wait to see what sort of responses we get. I imagine most of them, Alan, will be on your side. So you have nothing to worry about. Thank you very much indeed. Dr. Alan Mendoza, Executive Director of the Henry Jackson Society. What do you think?